Let us continue with the topic. Now observe this question. Engineering as a profession is dedicated to which of the following values it seems? Now one general question that you can answer very easily. Now you dedicate for safety, yes. Human progress, yes. Clean, clear decision making, yes. Community, yes. Partnership with nature, yes. Now see here, we have seen all the key values of engineering profession in the previous question also. Remodified question, this one, right? So your answer is D. Now see here, focus on the questions. After seeing the question bank also, you can attempt your examination very easily. Which of the following is not a form of conflict of interest? Again, we have seen the same type of question previously. Now by this time you can answer this. Moonlighting is a form of conflict interest. Insider information is a form of conflict of interest. Authority, no, it is not a form. Interest in other companies, yes, this is a form. So you are asked for answer, not a form. So your answer is C. Which of the following is not a dimension of professional integrity? Right, again we have seen this type of question similarly in the previous slides also. Now by this time you have to answer this, right? Easy picking. Answer is consistency is a professional integrity. Taking responsibility is a professional integrity. Being insular in approach, no, this is not a professional integrity. Being holistic in approach, yes, all round holistic means, right? So your option is C. You are asked to find out not a dimension. Next one. Which of the following is not a quality of professional engineer, it seems? Again, one more easy question. Now, integrity, yes, this is a quality. Impartiality, yes, this is a quality. Competence, yes, this is a quality. Professional growth, now this is not a quality, right? You must not consider this as a quality. So your option is D, as you are asked to find out, not a quality. Professional engineers are responsible for their own actions, is it correct? Yes. For duties accepted and implicit in their work and institutions, yes, right. For legal obligations imposed by contract, yes, they are responsible. For greater moral consequences of their action, yes, they are all responsible for all these activities. We have dealt all this in the video. Your option number A. Which one of the following statements are not correct? Now see, we are reverse engineering the questions, right? Now observe the options there. Confidentiality simply means not sharing client information. This is correct statement. A whistleblower is a person who reveals any policy of an organization to the public. Is it any policy? No, unethical matters. So your option number B is wrong. You are asked to find it not correct one. Automatically your B statement is perfectly right. Done. Easy pickings, right? Yes. Next one. Now see the next options also. Trust have the common element of belief, mutuality and predictability. Yes, we have seen this question also. The moral values held by an individual are during or lasting beliefs. Yes, perfect. It long last. Which of the following are correct in case of environmental ethics, it seems? And you are asked to find out the correct statements. Now which option is right? Respect towards natural resources, flora and fauna, yes, right. Quick decisions in matter related to environment, no, wrong. It's not quick decision, detailed decisions. Obligation to do no harm to the environment, yes, right. Quality of producing effectively with minimum waste of resources, yes, right. So your answers are 1, 3 and 4. Which of the following types of inquiries is based on values, it seems? Right? Now, based on values. Now, your option must go on to normative inquiry. Right? We have dealt all these things in detail. Next one. Consider the following statements regarding loyalty and you are asked to find out the correct option. Loyalty to companies or their owners should not be equated with merely obeying one's immediate supervisor? Yes, nearly not equated. Yes, correct statement. An engineer might have professional obligation to both an employer and to public that reinforce rather than contradict each other. Yes, perfectly correct. So your both statements are right. Now a little bit you have to be strong in vocabulary also. Which of the following statements are correct? Right, the main branches of ethics are applied ethics, yes, normative ethics, yes, meta ethics, yes, descriptive ethics, yes. So first statement is correct. Morality doesn't fall under any branch of ethics. No, it falls. Right, study of ethics in India is a new subject. No, wrong. So your option is A. Next one. A person with sound moral character is said to be possessing integrity. When applied to an organization, integrity to an environment in which self-serving interest exists. Self-serving interest. Is it working for his own interest? No, wrong. Fairness exists? Yes. Honesty abounds? Yes. Virtues and skills are balanced? Yes. So 2, 3, 4, your option number D exactly satisfies. Which of the following is not a moral value, it seems? Honesty is a moral value. Fairness is a moral value. Respect is a moral value. So your option is none of these. Theoretically, which of the following is not a form of dishonesty, it seems? Not a form of dishonesty. Lying is a form of dishonesty. Deliberate deception is a form of dishonesty. Withholding information, no, this is not a form of dishonesty. Corruption is a form of dishonesty. You are asked to find out not a form. So your C option exactly satisfies the things. Consider the following statements regarding types of ethics. Now, correct statements. Macroethics deals with societal problems which are unknown but can suddenly burst out on a regional or national level. Yes, perfectly right. So your option number one is correct. Microethics deals about everyday problems which play an important role in the field of engineering. Yes, perfectly right. So your option is C. Both are correct. Which of the following is not a mandatory criteria required for a profession? Knowledge, yes, it is required. Organization, yes, it is required. Public good, yes, it is required. Leadership quality, no, this is not required. So your answer is D. Which of the following can be referred as the bridge between the responsibility in private and personal life? Right? What is the bridge that you... Is it collegiality? Wrong. Is it compromising? No, wrong. Is it morality? No, wrong. It is the integrity which bridge between your private and personal life, right? How honest you are. Consider the following statements regarding ethical codes for engineers. Now see here, every year there will be a question based on these ethical codes. Now I have discussed all the ethical codes in the video in detail. Go through that and you can answer this question very, very easily. Right? Engineers shall respect the proprietary information and intellectual property rights of others. Yes, right. Engineers shall associate only with honest persons or organizations. Yes, right. Engineers shall hold paramount of safety, health and welfare of the public in the performance of their professional duties. Yes, right. So your options are 1, 2 and 3. Which of the following is not a general feature of morally responsible engineers, it seems? Right, now which is not a feature? Accountability is a morally responsible one. Autonomy is a morally responsible one. Comprehensive perspective is a morally responsible one. Now, collegiality is not a morally responsible one. Already I have discussed this in detail. right? So your answer is collegiality. See the previous slides, we have done the same question, right? Now, with reference to limitations of ethical codes, consider the following statements and you are asked to find out the correct statements. Codes cannot give a solution or method for solving the internal conflicts. Yes, right. Codes can be reproduced in a very rapid manner. Yes, very right. So, your answer is both 1 and 2. Which of the following categories of risk can be ignored, it seems? Now, one general question, you can ask the answer it easily. Low consequence and low probability, right? Easy picking. Which of the following are the reasons of conflict of interest? We have seen this type of questions many. Insider trading is a reason. Kickbacks is a reason. Bribe, yes, it is a reason. So your answer is all the above. Which of the following agreement is enforceable by law? Now see here, enforceable by law it seems, right? Is it illegal? No. The statement wrong. Void agreement? No. Valid agreement? Yes. This option is enforceable by law. Valid agreement. Easy picking. Consider the following statements regarding the ways to promote an ethical climate, it seems. How to promote an ethical climate? Now your options are, the management has to establish some procedure for resolving conflicts. Yes, depends upon the organization. The bottom level management must establish a moral tone in words, in policies, by personal examples. No, your senior level management must be there. So your second one is wrong. So your option is only one. Which of the following is not a condition to met for whistleblowing, it seems? Now your options are need. It is a condition. Capability. It is a condition. Plagiarism. No. Right. It's of intellectual property. The last retort. Yes. We have discussed all these points in the video clearly. Consider the following statements and find out the correct one. Employees must see some of their own important goals are met by and through a group in which they participate. Yes, group organizational behavior comes under this. Employees must be treated fairly, each receiving his or her share of benefits and burdens. Yes, perfectly right. So your answer is both 1 and 2. Which activity by a professional engineer would be considered unethical, it seems? Now which activity? Now your options are, not charging a fee for presenting a design. Now this is unethical. No, wrong. Reviewing the work of another professional without his consent. Yes, this is considered as unethical. So your option number B, providing professional services as consultant, it is considered ethical. Signing plan with thorough review, it is ethical. So your option B is perfect answer. Now, what is ethics in engineering profession? Now we have discussed this question n number of times. The study of business situations arising and decision taken by engineering professionals where issue of right or wrong are addressed. Yes. Your A statement is perfectly explaining things. Now, as per theory of virtue ethics. Now we have seen this question. An action is right if it supports good character traits. Yes, perfectly right. An action is wrong if it supports bad character traits. Yes, right. Personal character is defined vices and virtues of an individual. Yes, right. So your answer is all the above. Consider the following statements and you are asked to find out the correct statement. Self-esteem refers to the virtue properly valuing oneself, it seems. No. Self-esteem refers to virtue properly valuing oneself. No. Wrong. Self-respect means having a positive attitude towards oneself even if the attitude is unwarranted. No. bluntly wrong. Reverse statements given there. So your answer is neither one nor two. Simple questions. With reference to types of risk, consider the following statements. With reference to types of risk, consider the following statements, and you are asked to find out the correct statements there. In personal risk, an individual who is given sufficient information will be in a position to decide whether to take part in a risky activity or not. Yes, right. Public risks are generally involuntary in nature. Yes, right. So your answer is both 1 and 2 are right. Consider the following statements regarding whistleblowing. Now we have seen this type of questions many. Find out the correct one. Whistleblowing is morally permitted when one does not get satisfied from their immediate supervisors and exhaust the channels available within the organization. Yes, right. It is morally obligated when there must be strong evidence that making the information public will prevent the threatened serious harm. Yes, perfectly right. So your options are both 1 and 2 are correct. Which of the following are central elements of collegiality, it seems. Now we have discussed this many times. Cooperation, yes. Respect, yes. Commitment, yes. All these are central elements of collegiality. The prudency is proficiency in recognizing moral problems in engineering, no, wrong. Forming consistent viewpoint based on facts, this is also wrong. Searching alternate responses to issues and being receptive to creative solutions, wrong. Exercising good judgment in handling practical matters is the thing, right? So your option number D perfectly suits the answer. Which of the following statements regarding principle of beneficence are correct, it seems. Now, it imposes obligations to provide benefits and to prevent, remove harms to others. Yes, right. On one, how to prevent, remove evil or harm. Yes, right. This is the principle of beneficence. One, how to promote always good. Yes, this is right. So your options are all the above. What does theory of virtue ethics mean? And what does this exactly mean? Your options are: assumes good persons will make good decisions and personal qualities affect decisions. Now this is the theory of virtue ethics means. Now,